time for the first part of 2017, but the second part of 2017 was a different ball game altogether. So in May, I started with an episode of palpitations that led to an A&E visit, that led to another inpatient stay, and that was pretty much it every other month for the rest of 2017. It culminated in me having a little bit longer hospital stay, and unfortunately we had to cancel a holiday that we booked in the March. So throughout this entire year, to me, the ACHD nurses played a massive part. I literally would be on the phone every other month, every time I had a bout of palpitations, every time I wasn't sure how I felt. I would give them a call, we'd come up with a plan, we'd decide a course of action, and it was just that kind of reassurance that I needed. So throughout all the hospital appointments, the GP appointments, the INR checks and the cancelled holidays, which I will eventually forgive Petra for, but I always felt like as a team we were working for my health. So then things changed again. So I was then referred up to Newcastle and met Dr. Janssen and Dr. Sellers. And as soon as I met them, I felt completely at ease. I knew I was in the right hands. I knew that the Newcastle team knew exactly what they were doing. And I also knew that I now had two teams working for me rather than just the one. So I had a ablation up in Newcastle in 2017 in the June. And then we made the trip again in September for transplant tests. So the whole transplant test assessment thing is just something that I've literally just been saying is a kind of, it's happened, and the whole part of my attitude and the attitude of living with CHD is that you've kind of got to move on from it. So I'm not going to go into it in a lot of detail, but I saw various people and at no point did I ever feel like this had been the wrong decision or it's going to be a hard decision, or at any point did I feel alone in it. We were very supportive from the minute my boyfriend and I walked into the hospital. People who were part of that decision making team would come and speak to us. So it was like a home from home, despite the fact that we were so far from home. It wasn't a huge, it didn't feel like we were nowhere near family. So after the various tests, I was offered a TCPC conversion, but in discussion with the team, and again, being led by myself, we've decided that medication is the way forward for now. So since coming back from Newcastle, I've felt significantly better. And I think this is because we have actually got a plan in place now as opposed to the uncertainty. And yesterday I was in here, I was listening to some talks, and somebody had said a lot of stress about living with CHD is that you're sort of living under this cloud of uncertainty, so you never quite know what's going to happen. For myself, I never know whether I'm going to get up in the morning and have a normal day, or get up in the morning and it's going to end in an A&E visit or a call to the nurses. So it can be hard to live like that, but having this little bit of certainty and a plan going forward has really felt like it's turned a corner now. So, as I say, since then, life for me has been normal, and in fact, it's busier than ever. So I'm not obviously going to go without plugging Heart Hub, which is part of the reason why I'm here, and it would be stupid of me not to. But I just genuinely want to say, I'm going to try not to get upset about what I do. I just want to say a huge thank you to my nursing team, doctors. Sometimes it feels all a bit too much, and genuinely, this year, you guys have been my constant, and a constant for myself and my family. You've been a lighthouse in a storm, and I genuinely couldn't have done it without you, so thank you. That's my